greetings. There once was a small community. It had survived many generations. It survived because it followed the scriptures, the message of the prophets of their God. In this village, six friends had grown up as mighty leaders of their community. They grew up together and learned each other's strengths and weaknesses. They were such good friends, they always hung around each other. People began to call them the six wise brothers, even though they were not related. They were wise and all went to college. One even got his PhD. Their names were Mr. How, Mr. What, Mr. When, Mr. Why, Mr. Where, and Mr. Who. One day a stranger came to town, creating quite a stir. As he sat down at the diner, friendly people began chatting with him. The town was full of friendly, hospitable people who shared their faith. But the man shocked them by what he said. "I do not worship what you worship, because your scriptures were changed." And the diner was abuzz. People looked to and fro. Questions flew fast and furious at the stranger and his strange claim. The excited tone began to grow hostile and angry as people felt their religion was attacked and threatened. Finally, the sheriff had to put down his donut and escort the man safely back to his car. "Don't leave town, son. You've made some statements you need to answer for." And the town leaders scheduled an interview with the man to understand the source of his claims. And they invited the six wise friends to join the discussion, to call upon their famed wisdom. As the meeting began, the town leaders invited the man to clearly state his claim and his knowledge. The town loved the truth and listened to claims, no matter how wild or offensive it might initially be. "I follow the one true Allah," the stranger began. "The Allah I follow is the Lord of the worlds, not just this one." Someone mocked, "So you believe in little green aliens that follow your Allah?" And the gavel banged. Bam, bam, bam. "Let the stranger speak. We will show him respect, as is our way." The stranger continued, "The Allah I follow sent messengers, some of whom wrote the originals of the scriptures you follow. So my Allah is actually also your Allah. My Allah sent your scriptures, but evil people changed the scriptures to suit their sins." "That's quite a claim, stranger," one of the leaders said. "If what you claim is true, we'd like to follow this Allah that you present."
"Allah be praised," the man excitedly proclaimed.
"Not so fast, brother. That's a mighty big if that you will have to prove. We would like the wisest men in our town to discuss the matter with you, if you are willing. And if they can be convinced your claim is the truth, we will accept your claim and follow your religion." So the council meeting was paused, and the six wise friends came forward to the front row. When the meeting resumed, the leader began with an introduction. "Your claim, brother, is that our scriptures are not true because they have been changed. For now, that is the only point of discussion we will investigate. If our scriptures were changed, that is a matter of infinite and eternal consequence. If our scriptures are not changed, we know your claim is false, and nothing further need be discussed. We realize you may feel threatened and are all alone, but I give you our word that whatever the outcome, you will be allowed to stay in this town or leave this town in peace after we reach a conclusion." So the first of the wise men, Mr. Wen, came forward and began to speak. "Just to be clear, brother, you say that our scriptures have been changed, right?"
"Yes, the scriptures do not match the originals."
"My friend, the scriptures were written across 1,000 years of history. When was this alleged change made?"
"Moses wrote the Torah, so when was the Torah changed?"
The stranger had no answer. "After Moses, Joshua was leader, and other prophets followed. And would you agree, each messenger came with an opportunity to claim the prior had been changed?"
When did this chain of God's word being preserved get broken? We do not know, but it must have happened.
How do you know it happened? Mr. Howe piped in.
How could someone change all the copies in the world? How could you convince all the people to agree to the changes? How could you prevent them keeping their alleged originals?
The stranger had no answer.
Well, at least you can tell us what changed, Mr. What joined the fray.
What books were changed? What verses were changed? What doctrines and teachings were changed?
You have exceeded your religion, the stranger defended.
How so? Mr. Howe responded.
How is believing the prophets excessive? Mr. Howe responded.
Mr. Ware could hold his peace no longer.
Where are these original scriptures you claim existed? Where do you have them as evidence?
Where is any physical proof of your claim?
Where were these changes made? In what country? In what city?
The stranger was getting more and more agitated. He began to realize how empty his claim was.
He trusted his scriptures, but what could he say to answer these questioners?
At last, Mr. Who raised his hand and all eyes slowly turned to him.
Gentlemen, please be thoughtful. Old documents sometimes go missing.
And with this, the stranger smiled and shook his head.
Yes, yes, he said.
A more important question is, who would make any such changes?
Who could live in the culture of the covenant and despise the God who made it?
Who would think they could stand against the God who defeated Pharaoh?
Who would have access and control to change all the copies?
Earning my PhD, I studied this man's scriptures, religion, and its history. I have patiently listened to see if this stranger could reveal anything new. But he is not aware of the history of his own beliefs. So have some patience with him, brothers.
He thinks our scriptures were changed because his own scriptures were changed.
What are you talking about? Asked Mr. What.
How could that have happened? Asked Mr. Howe.
I want to know when, asked Mr. Wen.
Where is the important piece of the puzzle to me, brother?
Allow me to answer you, brother. I'll begin with who made these changes.
The changes to his scriptures were made by Caliph Uthman.
Where is in his kingdom, called the Caliphate. This was where the Caliph ruled.
When is during his reign, when he had conquered many territories.
How is by his authority. He commanded all to yield their copies, and he ultimately burned them.
What changed is sadly lost to the sands of time, because this man, the Caliph, ordered all the originals burned.
Brother, a soft voice finally spoke.
Yes, Mr. Y.
Brother, do you have any knowledge about why he, the Caliph, would make these changes?
Actually, the history records why. Those who follow this belief do so with a violent zeal.
In the Caliph's army, fighting was breaking out among those with different versions of their scriptures.
To save his army and his kingdom, the Caliph had to create a single version.
But, Mr. Y, is there a reason you have not questioned the stranger?
No, brother. I already know why this claim is made by the religion this man follows. When this man came to town, I borrowed his book for a few days.
It is short, and it is written by one man, and about one man.
He profited from writing his book and scaring men to follow him.
He gave himself special rights, such as more wives than his followers could have.
I had already formed my judgment, so I sat quietly as you all questioned the man.
He could not answer any of your questions with real answers.
He could not answer what changed or when it changed.
He could not answer who changed it or how older copies were destroyed. He could not answer where the changes were made, and I did not bother to ask why. But Brother Hu, you could answer all the questions. The evidence and the proof it supports is that his scriptures are changed and his claim is false. I will leave you each to form your own conclusions. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.